So it's hard to condense my Bethel experience into a short segment, but the most significant thing was Bethel's where I made my faith my own through classes like with Dr. Al Glenn, or in the dorms where we'd have debates about what does our faith mean and how are we going to live that out. I met Annie in freshman year. Been a wonderful journey since then, ups and downs. Annie is different than me in so many ways, and that's been great to have her soften me and help me remember who I am and to remain humble. And then we have four children that have just been such a gift to both of us. Recently, one of our children was going through something, and it just struck me that, you know, the challenges for young people, I realize, are different than the challenges I had. Yet in the midst of that, God is the same God. And so seeing the challenges our children have had or that students have today or that we'll have in the generations to come, there's the same God and the same truth. I was on a retreat with a group of young leaders from Azusa Pacific University. One of the exercises we were to do is to leave something on the mountain and take something down, a word. And I had been wrestling for the last couple of years of what I could do to use all my experiences, all the gifts that God had given me to glorify Him. And it felt like God was saying, hey Ross, look around you. This mountain, the wildflowers are screaming out my glory. It doesn't matter where you are or what you do. I will glorify myself through what you do. So on the way down, I called Annie and said, hey, I think I want to come in and offer my time over the next year to help out with strategy and finance with the Azusa Pacific. Little did I know that they were in the middle of, just within that week, grappling with a significant surprise financial loss that they had. And so instead of being this commitment that I thought was going to be a light touch, all of a sudden within 2 days was a significant commitment, hands-on and diving into this university in an organization that I had cared about but not been inside. We began a process of how do we turn this around. Clearly there were challenges that I was able to step into, and it was great to see God calling me into something that was not on my radar, was not where I thought God was going to lead me. What a preparation for this role. I could not have stepped from all those years of Medtronic directly into a role like this, but to have God given me those experiences, what a great foundation to know that I could apply those experiences to a Christian higher ed environment. The idea of living for God's glory has to me a variety of implications. One is that we do things with excellence, and then to look for ways to live out Christ and be his hands and his voice. It's encompassed everything that I've done. I think it's who I am, who I strive to be, is to live my life for the glory of God and to impact others. It's humbling to think of those that have come before. The leader of any organization I know makes a significant impact, and God uses that person uniquely. It's exciting to think of what we all can do here at Bethel in such a critical time as this, to step into the shoes of those that have come before. I'm excited about that and yet humbled and honored.